Okay, I'll do the first one. Okay, so Garbine, how exciting was it for you to return to Melbourne Park and play your match after all the success you had last year here?
Very excited. We had some crowd, which is great. So, I mean, it's good to be back. It's a new year. It's going to be a challenging year. And, I mean, I'm excited to start competing. I love Australia. I love the energy. And, like you said, I have good memories.
Okay. We'll switch to online, Louis.
Okay. Courtney from the WTA, could you please ask your question? You there, Courtney? Courtney, are you there?
They can't hear you, apparently. They're saying they can't hear you.
Courtney, could you ask your question, please?
Yep. Hi, Garbine. I hope you can hear me.
Yep.
Yep. Can you just talk through your performance today and what you were pleased with and just what the conditions were like? A little bit tricky, as it, I believe, was cooler tonight than it has been.
I mean, excited to start competing because, well, it's been a while since we're in Australia and finally we are here, we're competing, we have some crowd watching us, so it feels good to be in competition. It was tricky, actually. I think it's the first time in my life that I play with long sleeve in Australia in summer, but we all know that you never know in Melbourne, right? So I was prepared. No, I was also expecting to play at late match and, you know, it can be fresh. But, yeah, very excited to get this first round.
I saw that you posted on your social media a very excited video of you after being released from quarantine. And I'm curious just kind of what that process was like, the 2 weeks, and then also what were the first things that you wanted to do the minute that you kind of had your freedom?
I mean, it was a challenge. I think I was pretty lucky to be able to have the 5-hour practice and to get out of the hotel. And, you know, I think other colleagues were, it was tougher. But I think we had a good energy and, you know, obviously very happy when we got out. I think the first thing I did, I don't know, probably have a beer. I don't know, in the beach. You know, we went right away to the beach and just to be outside and, I don't know, be, you know, watching the ocean and being able to have a nice lunch with people in a restaurant. You know, these little things that we took for granted before, now, you know, they're great. But, yeah, probably a beer was the most needed thing.
Does it feel weird to be able to kind of now walk around freely and, you know, yeah, sit next to people at a restaurant and do things that for a lot of us, you know, we can't do and have not done for almost a year?
It feels weird. You know, actually, I got a lot of messages from people in Europe saying, what's going on? Why are you not wearing a mask? You know, they were like, what's happening? And, you know, I was explaining that here, you know, fortunately, they did well and there's no cases, and that's why people are having a normal life. But it is weird because coming from Europe, it's very different and it's getting worse. So yeah, we're very excited to be in a normal, like nothing happened almost, right? We left Australia with no COVID and we come back and it's still similar.
Yeah, it's an interesting situation. Just in terms of preparing for not just this week, but also for a slam under kind of these sort of conditions, which we've never kind of really had to deal with before. What has been the trickiest part for you? And what do you think is the key for you to be able to go into the Australian Open feeling as quote unquote normal for slam preparation as you would want?
I mean, I cannot compare it to anything else. Like you said, it's a very different circumstance. I feel like I was lucky to have enough time to play on the courts, to prepare actually in the same place where the Grand Slam is going to happen. Even I have the chance to play a tournament before, so it's actually too long, right, to be here. But no, I think it's great. It's very exciting, all the effort that they put together to make it happen, and I'm just trying to adapt, you know, every little moment, playing a tournament in the club where you're going to play a Grand Slam after. It feels weird, right? Because I'm like, am I playing here? What is this? You know, it's a Grand Slam. No, it's not yet. But it's all good. I mean, it's a good problem to have. No bad energy.
And just last question from me. Looking ahead, you'll play Pavlyuchenkova. Obviously a tough opponent. She's playing well. Can you just talk about that matchup and what is the key for you?
Yeah, I mean, we played many times. I think she's a very aggressive player. She has achieved great results. We always had good battles. And it's a good match to play. I feel it's a good test. Another match to prepare, to progress into the competition this year. And I'm looking forward. All these matches, I'm excited to play.
Okay, we'll move to questions in Spanish. Nacho, could you please ask your question and also turn your camera on? Thank you.
Hola, se me ve, supongo ya, y se me escucha, creo.
Uh-huh, sí.
¿Qué tal, Garbiñe? Se te ha visto pegándole a la bola con mucha confianza, como con ganas, con profundidad. ¿Tú lo has sentido así hoy en la pista? ¿Te has sentido bien en ese sentido, lo que es la sensación de lado con la bola?
Me he sentido bien, la verdad. He estado esperando bastante por el partido y, bueno, he tenido tiempo para prepararme. Yo creo que también eso me ha ayudado a entrar en la pista quizá con más certeza, pero bueno, creo que he jugado muy bien, creo que he aprovechado desde el primer momento esa ventaja en el marcador y en el segundo set también me he puesto por delante bastante rápido y eso me ha ayudado a desplegar mi tenis de una manera más tranquila.
Gracias.
Okay, next question. Ángel.
Enhorabuena, Garbiñe. Yo quería preguntarte, estando tan cerca a un gran slam, siendo una situación tan rara de que habéis estado confinados y demás, ¿hasta qué punto es importante para ti hacerlo bien en este torneo para llegar bien al gran objetivo que evidentemente es Australia?
Bueno, a ver, normalmente no soy una jugadora que le gusta jugar los torneos previos, la semana justo anterior a un gran slam. Pero creo que estando ya aquí, teniendo la oportunidad de competir, jugar partidos, mi intención es hacer todo lo que ya he estado trabajando, ponerlo en los partidos, adaptarme ya a la pista lo máximo posible, intentar ganar, lógicamente. Pero bueno, como normalmente no suelo jugar antes, estoy contenta de jugar, la verdad. Es que ya estoy en el sitio, ¿no? Es como que podría ser también un partido de Grand Slam. Entonces, me lo estoy tomando de bien. Un entrenamiento, competición previo.
¿Y eso os pasa a varios, lo de no jugar la semana previa a un Grand Slam, uh-huh, o lo que soléis hacer varios y este año habéis tenido, uh-huh, que cambiarlo? ¿Qué cambias a nivel práctico o a nivel real? ¿Qué cambios haces teniendo que jugar la semana previa a un Grand?
Bueno, te pones en modo competición más rápido, quizá no te reservas tanto para el Grand Slam, sino la puesta a punto es antes, porque ya sales a competir, ya tienes las contrincantes, que realmente te vas a encontrar las mismas la semana que viene. Al final, el torneo puede ser diferente, pero no deja de ser la misma contrincante. Pero yo creo que es eso, sin más, saltar ya al ruedo antes y luego empatar con un Grand Slam. No es que nunca lo haya hecho, sí que es cierto que en determinados momentos he querido jugar la semana anterior, pues porque me apetece jugar más partidos, porque esto, lo otro, ¿no? Pero bueno, ahora lo estoy tomando de buena manera. Es una buena oportunidad para competir. Tampoco se sabe mucho cómo va a ser la situación, así que aprovecharé esta oportunidad.
Y la última por mi parte. Cuando vienes de un grandísimo resultado el año pasado en el mismo torneo, ¿eso te genera algo más de presión? ¿Miras el ranking o simplemente tú juegas este año, tu temporada y te olvidas?
Realmente, bueno, lo del ranking ya no miro nada, pero no, yo creo que este año también es bastante raro. Bueno, sí, he jugado bien el año pasado, sí que tengo esa sensación, ¿no?, de querer volver a jugar bien, sobre todo en sitios que sabes que tu tenis ha salido bien, pero no más de lo normal, no más de lo normal. Es cierto que quizá cuando era antes sí que me ponía más nerviosa, sobre todo cuando llegas a un torneo en el que has jugado muy bien, ¿no?, tienes los ojos un poco y te sientes, esa responsabilidad. Este año, Bueno, este año no, no tanto, la verdad. Yo creo que es por todo lo que está pasando también, que es como, mira, vamos a jugar, a ver qué tal sale, nos adaptamos y, bueno, más en ese plan.
Muchas gracias.
Garbiñe, thank you for your time. That concludes our press conference.
All right.